Hey there, welcome. Few things in life are as addictive as this cheese bread. It's crispy outside and gooey inside, will make you come for it over and over again. Originally from Minas Gerais in Brazil, this recipe has now traveled the world, and my version will make you obsessed by them. Let's cook. To start, you need this special flour. This bread will not work with any other flour. This is starch obtained from the cassava roots and becomes this super thin powder. This will give our bread its special consistency. I will leave a link in the description for this product, but you can also look for it in any Brazilian stores around where you live.
Add the starch and the salt into our mixer bowl. I'm using a mixer for ease here, but you can also do it by hand. There's just a small thing you need to watch for, but I will tell you about it in a minute. In a pot, we add our liquids, our milk, water and oil, and bring it to a boil, and as soon as it starts boiling, we remove it from the heat. Slowly add our liquid into the mixer. We want to scorch the starch. This is a super important step as it will make the starch become gelatinous and create a gorgeous texture in our bread. After all the liquid is in, let it mix for a couple of minutes until the dough becomes uniform and smooth.
Remember when I said you could do it by hand? Here you need to use a wooden spoon to keep mixing it all together, as the starch will be piping hot. A little bit of handwork, but in 5 minutes, you'll get the mixture ready too. Once it's all together and has cooled down a little, we can add our eggs in. We didn't do it before because the hot liquid could cook the eggs and it would give you an eggy flavor to the bread. We don't want that. When the eggs are mixed, I add the cheese. You can use any cheese of your preference, just be aware of the salt level of the cheese you use and reduce the salt in the beginning if you're using a very salty cheese. To finish our mix, I'll add baking powder, not traditional, but it creates the perfect texture for me. Let everything mix until uniform. We can increase the speed to medium and let it mix for 3 to 4 minutes. And while the dough comes together, subscribe for more delicious recipes like this one. On a baking tray, I will spread some vegetable oil. And the biggest trick to form these balls is just to use gloves and cover them in oil. This is kids' play. I'm eyeballing the size of the breads, but if you want, you can weigh them. It's really up to you. I like this size, but you can go bigger if you want. But size isn't everything. You can also freeze the balls and cook them when needed. It will make your life so much easier in the future. Freeze them in an oil tray, and after frozen, transfer them to a plastic bag, and they will not stick to each other by then. Back to the tray, make sure you leave enough space between them as they will grow. Set it in the oven at 190 degrees Celsius or 375 Fahrenheit for 30 to 35 minutes or until the top is light golden brown. I will turn the tray halfway through to make sure they even cook. And you can see how they're getting by now. Wow, they look amazing. Make sure you put them on a cooling rack or they might collapse. After 20 minutes, time to try this beauty. Just look how good they look. Amazing. Let's taste. Oh. Gooey, salty, soft, yum. Absolutely delicious. This is an amazing food. The worst part is I can't stop eating it. Spread some any type of cream cheese in them, prosciutto, my favorite, butter and ham. It's just delicious. Eat it while you have a coffee, just perfect. And in less than 60 minutes, you have an amazing snack to eat. Less if you did it from frozen. Definitely give it a try, I recommend it. And as addictive as this is, you can't eat this all the time, can you? Can you? Well, you shouldn't, right? So this video here will give you another snack you cannot live without. The last piece is for me. See you there. Bye.